All right, welcome back. We've got some cool clouds close to the continental divide, some freestanding mountain wave clouds. You can kind of see one wave right there, and then behind that a little clearing, and then behind that, if I could turn the camera, you'd see yet another cloud. 48 degrees, gusts still to 24 miles per hour in Helena and in Great Falls. Still looking at some pretty good wind out there, 46 degrees, some gusts to 36. I had some gusts up over 50 miles per hour in Great Falls earlier today. The wind, cool temperatures, some showers of rain and snow. Not a very nice day. The wind's still pretty strong. However, as I showed you in our first check of the weather, the high wind warning has really been allowed to expire for most of the area. Still some gusts though, 44 miles per hour in Lewistown, 33 mile per hour gusts into Cup Bank. Wind eases up but doesn't shut off completely. And then tomorrow, it's more of a southwest warmer wind that will be moving across the state. And then Friday looks pretty windy, but we'll likely have a wind shift late in the afternoon, the evening, with a cold front moving through. On the radar, as I mentioned, some showers of mixed rain and snow, things really quieting down across the north central part of the state. Still some snow up into the Bob and the Scapegoat as well, the Sapphire and Bitterroot Mountains. And that blob of green is the warm front that will be heading into the state tonight and tomorrow. Central part of the country, we've got some rain there, and boy, it was a mess of a storm into New England with a major nor'easter out there. Still hundreds of thousands of people without power. Here comes the next storm, though, and a mix of rain and snow, depending on elevation, coming through the overnight into tomorrow morning. Tomorrow morning, places like Fletcher Pass, Rogers Pass, even McDonald Pass could have a little snow. But then as the warmer air moves in, snow levels will be rising through the morning hours into the afternoon. And it's mainly just rain, even into the mountains as we get into Thursday night. Thursday will be a mild night. Some places may not have lows down below the 50 degree mark here. That's pretty warm. Friday, partly cloudy and a warm start. And then here comes the front, rain changing over to snow as we go through Friday evening and Friday night into Saturday morning. A few spots, north central, south central Montana, could have coating up to an inch or maybe even 2 inches into the lower elevations. Tonight, the wind continues across the plains and it will be chilly with lows really in the 30s for most locations. And again, tomorrow morning, mountain passes on the continental divide could have a little sloppy snow. Warmer air moving in tomorrow, temperatures in the upper 50s to around 60 degrees. A lot of cloud cover central and western Montana. A little more sunshine the farther east you go. Friday will start out with sun and mild temperatures, but here comes the front late in the afternoon, the evening. How about that? 60s, even maybe the lower 70s out around Glasgow and Jordan. Behind the front, though, temperatures will be falling into the 30s by late Friday evening, and a little light snow, maybe a little light accumulation Friday night into Saturday morning. How about these temperatures here? Highs only in the 30s and the 40s on Saturday. Snow showers mainly in the morning, a little increase in some sunshine by the afternoon. It's a tongue twister. And then for Halloween, yeah, cold, not snow, not looking at a lot of wind, just crisp temperatures, highs in the 30s and the 40s. Trick or treat time, I'm gonna say around 6, 7 o'clock, 5 o'clock in the evening, temperatures will be falling down below the freezing point here. Could have a little light snow Tuesday night into Wednesday. And for Great Falls, some big changes this weekend and early next week.